why this is important legislation for Ohio. And first I'll introduce Camille Wimbish, who has done so much work to promote pro-voter policies in Ohio and really represents millions of Ohio voters through the various organizations that she is here representing today. So, Camille.
Good morning, my name is Camille Wimbish. I'm with the Ohio Voter Rights Coalition. We're a network of nonpartisan voter advocates dedicated to free, fair, and accessible elections. And I'm here to support House Bill 14. We are tremendously excited about the opportunity to have automatic voter registration in Ohio. It certainly is more convenient for voters. It's going to lead to more accurate voter rolls for both voters and election officials who struggle with trying to read handwriting. And it's also going to be produced tremendous cost savings. As Representative Clyde mentioned, a number of states have already introduced and implemented online automatic voter registration, and those include red states and blue states. So the blue states, people know about Oregon and they know about California, but there are also red states, Alaska and West Virginia, who have implemented or passed automatic voter registration. So we're urging the Ohio legislature to take this legislation seriously and to look at all the benefits that it has. As Representative Clyde mentioned, there are really no drawbacks to this important legislation. And now,
thank you so much. My name is Janetta King. I serve as the president of Innovation Ohio. Thank you, Representative Clyde. Ohioans are really fortunate to have your leadership on this issue. Representative Clyde is a great example of an elected official who not only is able to represent the people in her district, but she is a tremendous asset for all of Ohioans because of her expertise on this issue. You really understand these voting and election issues like few others, and we all benefit from her work. And really her lifting up these fundamental tenets of our democracy. So what you're bringing forward today in House Bill 14, I especially appreciate because it is steeped in good public policy, doable public policy, credible research, best practices, which is very, very important. And again, House Bill 14 is steeped in the tenets of our democracy. In the early 2000s, I had the opportunity to be part of two different international elections monitoring teams, one in Kosovo and one in Bosnia. I've been reflecting this week about those experiences because on Monday, the trial started for the former Bosnian Serbs who are being charged in the 1995 Srebrenica massacre. So this part of the world's been on my mind. New democracies have been on my mind. And elections monitoring teams, they go in for a few weeks and we do training, oversee the elections and stay a few days after to do the reporting. And that's what we did. But in advance of our arrival, months and months were spent registering as many people as possible to take part in these elections in these new democracies. And they did it with a really tough infrastructure. These were war-torn countries with not a lot of work to work with, but again, they were committed to using the infrastructure that they had to get as many people registered as possible. Because that was part of setting the stage for the successful ushering in of a democracy. You had to have all of those things in place. And the same tenet should apply to our democracy today. That those principles that they used about using their infrastructure to the best of their ability to ensure the widespread participation should be exactly what we want to do to improve our democracy. So going into a war-torn country to help nurture democracy really gave me the perspective about the special thing that we have here in our country and in our state, and we must never become complacent. We must never become lazy. We should always be looking for those opportunities to protect and strengthen what we have. And that's what House Bill 14 is about. We are living in a time when our democracy is being tested. We are having very direct conversations about the role of free press should play in our democracy, the judiciary's role in our democracy. And through all of these debates, we are going to be required to affirm and reaffirm our commitment to our beloved democracy that we have and to ensure its survival and to strengthen it. And House Bill 14 is one of the ways that we can do that. Thank you.
All right.